You bring your phone everywhere. Work, school, the movies. Now you can bring it to an Xfinity store for an easy way to switch to Xfinity Mobile, a new kind of network designed to save you money. You can get up to 5 lines of talk and text included with Xfinity Internet at no extra cost, so all you pay for is data. It's never been easier to switch to Xfinity Mobile and keep the phone you love. Click here to see how. Sorry, I gotta take this. Restrictions apply. Limited to select mobile phones. Requires activation of a new line of Xfinity Mobile. Up to 5 devices per account. New Xfinity Internet customers limited to up to 2 lines pending activation of Internet service.
Blog Talk Radio.
Blog Talk Radio / 2RAW4TV, man. I'm too raw for the TV.
Gangsta, but I'm still
revolutionary. I think it's time for revolution. No prepping my neck for nuisance, cause I'm a peace rider, cut the street. They view me as a nuisance, but I'm the smartest, the coolest, the hood. Young Isaac Newton, what trouble, war revolution. Hate crimes, robbing and boosting, man. Life is crazy, but police pull up and start shooting. Who the fuck is gonna stop it, man? What the fuck is solution? Shit is real, it's 3D. I don't hear, you ain't gotta believe me. Man, we just say the shit that the couch can't say on TV. I'm too raw. I'm too raw for the TV. Show it's the shit, we can real talk and drop the hit. Get too raw for TV, better bring your computer, don't get it. Cause it's on 3, 2, 1, live in your home. At the B is what it is, call a sequence on your song. I know everybody gon' feel it. Too raw for TV, the realest. Where Brandy Monster's taking it, Palmetto gonna kill it. I'm too raw for the TV.
I'm too raw for the TV.
Gotta believe me. I'm too raw for TV.
If you hear my voice, then you're part of the revolution. Welcome to the new world. This is your host, the Ratchet Revolutionary, Palmetto Star. Hey, hit me up on Twitter at Palmetto_Star. Heal the goddess, heal the world. We're talking about activating, healing, and uplifting the goddess and healing the world by doing so. So you guys definitely want to be a part of that. We got one of the most poignant and consciously explosive speakers out right now, Young Pharaoh. He's on the line with us. It's going to be a dynamic show, and we're going to reveal a lot of stuff that you may not have heard about before. So you're not going to see this on CNN. It's too raw for TV. So this would be a perfect time to get on Snapchat, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Let them know that the revolution will not be televised. It's too raw for TV. But, of course, you know I have my nigga from Nigeria, Ernest Paul. He does the heat every week. That means the top song from Africa or Europe. So we're going to go in on that. But what do you think? How can we effectively heal are women. What do you do when mama's hurting? Right now, black women and girls are being targeted, hunted, and attacked by agents of a fallen regime. They are being assaulted on all levels, mind, body, and soul, with no reverence to her divinity. If there was no black woman, there would be no civilization, no society, or humans. She was the first warrior, the first god, and the mother of us all. A nation can rise no higher than this woman. And we're going to talk about how we're going to heal our black woman and heal ourselves in the process. So this is a great show to definitely call in. Press 1 if you want to speak. I see a lot of callers on the line. I promise you I'm going to get to you. But you guys got to press 1 so I know that you want to speak. So we're going to go in on that. And, of course, my nigga from Nigeria, Ernest Paul, he's our eyes and ears out there in Nigeria. So you guys stay tuned. It's The Heat with Ernest Paul. We're coming back. We have Young Pharaoh on the line as well. So you guys call in 516-453-9174. Going in, it's 2RAW4TV. Oh, hold on for 1 second, you guys. Got Ernest Paul coming up right now. Hold on.
Heat with Ernest Paul. It's too raw.
This is The Heat with Ernest Paul on 2RAW4TV, bringing you top songs of the week in Africa and also in Europe. Guess what? This week we definitely put our hands on something big. Yes, I'm talking about what's big, what's happening in Nigeria. It's all about fathers and son love. Yes, that is what it's all about right over now. And before I let you into that, I just got to say this. Happy New Week to everybody out there listening all over the world. If you're in Jamaica, if you're in UK, if you're in US, if you're even in Afghanistan or Iran, in Nigeria, in Ghana, I'm saying happy, blessed New Week to you all. And this is The Heat with Ernest Paul on 2RAW4TV. So I'm so glad that you guys are listening. I think about 2 days ago, I was talking about food. I ate watermelon, so I was like, okay, food. I kind of love this food, so what do you think about this food? And the person said, okay, I love banana, I love all that, but I asked, what is your favorite food? I don't know. I'll be asking my listeners today, what is their favorite food? I love watermelon, so watermelon happens to be my favorite food. That's watermelon. Yes, it happens to be my favorite food. I don't know about you, but that is the question I'm going to be asking you guys today. What is your favorite food? Mine is watermelon. I want to know about you guys. So this is what is really happening in Nigeria right about now before we proceed to the top song of the week in Africa or in Europe. So you guys are going to find out what week we're going to be talking about, what song we're going to be airing on this with Ernest Paul on 2RAW4TV when it comes to top song of the week. Now, this is what is happening in Nigeria right now. The acting president, known as Osinbajo, the vice president of Nigeria, said Buhari treats him like a son. Yes, that is what he's saying. That is what he's telling everybody right about now, that Buhari is treating him like his son. I think he traveled down to Katsina. So where he was at Katsina, he was treated very, very well. So and that is the place, that is the home of the President Muhammad Buhari. That is his home. Katsina is his home. So when he went there to see Buhari, he was being treated like his son. So you could imagine a Yoruba man in Nigeria making friends with an Hausa man, especially a Yoruba man, going to the northern side where he was accepted. So that is good. You know, the Yorubas and the Hausas, they're not too friendly. So, but coming from him, so he said that to a press conference due to the handing over of the nation to him, because, like I said last week ago, that two medical people they came to Nigeria, a British and the other one a Caucasian. They came to know about the health of the president, and also they came to treat him. So I think that aspect didn't really go well. So they want to take it to another level. So now he's departing Nigeria for UK once more for further treatment. That is what he is doing. So he has handed over the nation to the vice president, the acting president right now, Osibanjo. So due to the handing over of the nation to Osibanjo, Osibanjo has this to say, and he's telling the whole world, especially Nigerians, that the president is treating him like a son. I love that. I want to ask this question. I don't know, but how many of us are being treated like a son in our place of work, especially treatment from our bosses? I know mine is kind of lovely. I love the way I'm being treated at 2RAW4TV, and I'm so, so happy about that. So, okay, now I'm moving to the next amazing story that we're having. Labor threatens nationwide strike over non-review of minimum wage. So labor, they are responsible for the well-being of workers in Nigeria. So now, what they are saying is this: they've threatened a nationwide strike. I think they've threatened the government with this strike, saying if they don't review the minimum pay of workers in Nigeria, they are going to strike. So they've said it, they've threatened them. So let's see how all of these are going to pan out to be. And they made this known due to a press conference where they let their heart out, saying that an angry man is an angry man. So they are hungry right now. Nigerians are hungry, especially the workers that are working in Nigeria. They are hungry. Things are not really going well. We have food items being high in the market. The prices are high in the market, and the government are not increasing the pay of the workers. So it's making them to go hungry, and they are angry. So the workers, the labor are saying that increase the pay, as we go on strike. So those are the amazing stories in Nigeria. Right now, we're moving to a special segment known as the top song of the heat with an spot on 2RAW4TV. This is the top song of the week with an spot on 2RAW4TV. And this is Post Malone featuring Quavo with his amazing, lovely song, and together they both called this song Congratulations. And I just got to say shout out to Post Malone on this song. He talked about his life and also how far he had been with him, the struggle and all that, but finally he made it and he's congratulating himself and all that. So I just got to say congratulations to everybody out there that celebrated their birthday over the week, especially me, and also people that are celebrating their birthday this particular week today. I'm saying happy birthday to you all, and also congratulations to you all. And also in football, I don't know, many of you would love sports, but I love sports as well. So Real Madrid won against Atletico. They lost the match against Atletico, but it signified it made them to, because of the aggregate score line, so they are through to the final, where they are going to take on Juventus on the 3rd of June. So Man United played today. They drew 1-1, so but they are in the final due to the aggregate score line as well. So aggregate score line is 2-1. So they won over Celta Vigo, and that score line is 2-1 on aggregate, based on aggregate score line, because of the first leg encounter that they had. They won that 1-0. So the match that they played today, it was 1-1. So it qualified them to the final. So congratulations to all of them. This is the top song of the week in Europe. Now I'm presenting to you Post Malone with his beautiful song titled Congratulations on the Hit with Tennis Spot on 2RAW4TV.
All right, all right, all right. Hey, Hit up Ernest Paul right now on Twitter, y'all. I know you're on there. At @I_MEP. Broadcaster, artist, and he gets those beats, y'all. So hit him up. He gets those beats. So big time shout out to him. He's our eyes and ears out there in Nigeria. We're coming back with Young Pharaoh. Hail the goddess and hail the world. It's going down tonight. I see all the callers on the line. Remember to press 1-516-453-9174. The revolution will not be televised. It's 2RAW4TV.
Mama call, see you on TV. Sunset shit done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. They was never friendly, yeah. Now I'm jumping out of Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I be itching like I had it, yeah. I'm surrounded 20 babies, yeah. But they didn't know me last year, yeah. Everyone wanna act like they important, but all that mean nothing when I saw my door, yeah. Everyone counting on me, drop the ball, yeah. Everything custom like I'm at the bottom. Yeah, yeah. If you fuck with winning, put your lattice to the sky. How could I make sense when I got millions on my mind? Coming with that bullshit, I just put it to the side. Bought a sense of baby, they could see it in my eyes. My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset shit done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. I was patient, yeah. Oh, I was patient, hey, oh. Now I can scream that we made it. Now everywhere I go, they say congratulations. Young nigga, graduation, yeah. I pick up the rock and I ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But right now I got a situation. Never old being frank, yeah. Big ring, champagne. My life is like a ball game. But instead I'm in a trap, though. Paso big, call it Super Bowl. Super Bowl, call the hoes. Get in the rows. Top blow lifestyle. Hunter and post. Malone, I got a play on my phone. You know what I'm on. Hunter Houdini is gone. My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset shit done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had
Hail the goddess, hail the world. Now, my next guest has captured a generation with crystal clear consciousness. He's a speaker, a spiritualist, and a swami. We have Young Pharaoh on the line. Peace, God. You with us?
Peace. What's going on with you?
Man, everything is excellent, supreme. But, you know, we're talking about hail the goddess, hail the world. And I know that you know, you go in talking about the black woman as God and the divinity of our women, you know what I'm saying, and how essential that is for us right now. So, you know, there's a lot of things that we can do to help out the women, a lot of, you know, that we put in our own lives and practice and stuff like that. But I just want to get your take on how important it is to heal our women right now, you know.
I mean, I think it's always been important. And as far as right now, I don't want to say it's more important than ever because it's always been and going to be a top priority, but it needs to be the primary focus of the black community. And most importantly, black women need to heal themselves by stop allowing bullshit. Because, you know, you can't hold somebody, you can't expect somebody to perform at a standard you don't hold them to. For example, the military, the military is not going to, let's say, lessen the amount of miles that a motherfucker got to run to become a Marine because you, a motherfucker in particular, can't run that time. Nigga, you just don't make it into the military. So black women is going to have to start enforcing the criteria that the black man must, let's say, uphold in order to be with her, or they're going to have to stop dealing with niggas. That don't mean go run to another race, but y'all going to have to go on strike or something. So, you know, it's very important that we uphold the black woman, but the black woman can't become so lost in the understanding of what the black man needs to do that she forget she herself is the first upholder of her own self. Because people are only going to treat you how you allow yourself to be treated. And a lot of this, in regards to the way we treat black women, is their fault. Because I'll give an example, you know, before I, you know, allow the next question to be introduced. You can say all you want, oh, listen to rap music. Listen to how they talk about black women. They the ones dancing in the goddamn video. So you approving it. You can't be mad at Future for naming his song Freak Hoes when you the one in the damn song dancing to Freak Hoes. So you are just as much at fault, if not more, for allowing yourself to be degraded. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's very important that we uplift our black women. That should be the primary focus of the black man in 2017. But it should also be the primary focus of a black woman, of a black woman, to carry herself in a manner to which somebody will be forced to respect her. See, people don't gotta like you, but they do have to respect you. And people respect you predicated upon the way they perceive you. And black women have allowed their image to become distorted and misunderstood, as well as highly misrepresented. So it's up to black women to take back the proper image of themselves and get rid of the artificial hybrid image of the black woman, which is technically not who she is and is actually who she'll never be, period.
Oh, that's profound. But don't you think that particular image that you're speaking about is being perpetuated not by the black woman that is represented by the, you know, that's not who the black woman is. That is a perception of what a demonic fantasy of the black woman. And they are sort of almost, you know, they're almost like paid, bribed to portray this image. And a lot of them are not even that. You know what I'm saying? I know a lot of strippers that's conscious. You feel me? It's like they're not even that. It's like you know, they are paid. They're given these trinkets that people equate to freedom. You know what I'm saying? And it's not them. It's just the image that's portrayed. But I do agree that we do need to, you know, and women need to be in the forefront of that movement as far as like showing what the true goddess is. But what do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. We're going in with young Pharaoh. Heal the goddess, heal the world. Very important. and you know we're all saying this. We're going to get into the sex magic tantra. We're going to talk about all of the stuff that is very essential right now. So you guys call in, put it on Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook. I see a lot of people on the line. I do want to get to some of the callers before we get into the meat, until we get into Raw. You know what I'm saying? I just want to get to one of the callers before, at least before we do that. 470, you're on the line with 2RAW4TV and Young Pharaoh.
Hey, first off, I just want to say peace to the brother Chief, man. I appreciate you doing this bi-metal, as I say every week, man. I want to send a shout out before I get started to my brothers in the Huey P. Newton Gun Club and to my sister unit, Black Panthers, New Era, Urban Sharpshooters, and the rest of the gentlemen. If I forgot anybody, I didn't mean to. Second, I want to say, man, it's an honor to be on the radio with Young Pharaoh, man. I've followed and admired his works, man, and look forward to doing work alongside him in the future about this. About the situation that we're in. I agree with man, 99% of what Pharaoh says, man. He's a very enlightened young man, which is why I follow him. And we do need to protect our sisters, man, but I think that more than us focusing on the goddess, man, the brother needs to be healed too. I think that it's a mutual healing that needs to take place, man, because if we simply focus on our sisters, then that's a focus that we're not using on our brothers. Man, these brothers need healing bad, man. Some of these brothers so thugged out that they need the healing hands of a queen. Some of these brothers, you know, done crossed over that homosexual line and need the healing of a queen. I was looking online one day on Facebook one day, and a brother had on there. He said, "I know I was gay in the past, but I have the urge." You know, lately I've had the urge to be loved by a queen. You know what I'm saying? This fad shit is dying out. This gay fad shit is dying out, and this hunky is gonna do everything he can to keep us on this effeminate bullshit. Keep all these faggot ass rappers, Baby, Puff Daddy, all these gay ass actors, Jamie Foxx, all these punks, you know, wearing skirts and dresses and all of that stuff, man, to keep us on this effeminate bullshit. So the male, the black male, man. He needs to be loved in the appropriate way. I've said before in speeches that I've given before, we'll be the first army in the history of mankind whose woman has an active role in the victory. Because when that man comes home, that woman is the black woman is a natural spiritual healer. So when that man comes off the battlefield, man, he needs to come to the loving arms of that black woman. And vice versa, she needs to feel like when he's going off, you know what I'm saying, when he's not there, he's off defending his village. And that's our natural order. We're a tribal people. We're a loving people. We're the equality people. We know that there's a yin and there's a yang. There's a positive and a negative, not negative in the sense of bad, but negative in the sense of the accentuation of positive. We know that there all of that, what's the term I'm looking for? It always slips my mind. The feminine versus the masculine. If it were not for the feminine, then we'd all be savages. But if it were not for the masculine, then we would not be able to build anything or protect anything. So there has to be neither is better than the other. They balance each other. They have to balance each other. And the only one that does not know this the only one that this is natural to is the black man and black woman. For everyone else, it's the woman on bottom and the man on top. Always. Always. May your first child be a masculine child. Black people don't give a shit about that. Black people just want a healthy child because we love. They're all about masculine, dominant, dominant, dominant. That's their culture. That's not ours, man. So Pharaoh, yeah, I agree with everything you say, brother. I follow you a lot. I don't like when you be beefing. I don't like when you even entertain other cats' beefs, man, because you're far, far, far too intelligent. I think... And I'll probably speak for the majority of the audience. You spend too much energy on those guys, brother. If you write, man, keep teaching, because what it'll do is it'll turn off somebody who's more on the intellectual side, because they have to bring their frequency down to understand who you're even talking about and what you're talking about. But you, man, you go so deep. I just ask, you know, and probably for the sake of the fans, man, stay deep, man. Don't even entertain them other brothers, man, because it's a waste of energy. That's all I got to you. I'll probably chime in a little later on. I appreciate it, brother.
That's right. That's love. That's definitely loved and appreciated, you are. Definitely.
Yeah. You're a good dude, man.
No doubt.
I'm sorry, go ahead, brother.
I was saying the other Sadiq of the Huey P. Newton Gun Club, definitely y'all need to definitely get in touch with them. We are, you know, building the resistance out there in Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? Definitely need to get in line and get in tune with that, you know, out here in Atlanta and, you know, all over. We need to protect ourselves. We need to protect our people, period. So big time shout out to you. Yeah, just hold on the line, Sadiq, and we're going to go in further on this discussion. And I am going to get to all the callers. Remember to press 1 so I know that you want to speak. Call in 516-453-9174. Now, I do want to talk a lot more about this, but I want to know, Young Pharaoh, just for the people that are listening and just may be the first time they have heard you, how did you get into your teachings, how did you get into your knowledge that you have right now?
As far as the amount of information that I have right now, it comes from constant studying and searching. And I'm a constant critiquer of myself, and I always double back on information that I have put out and fact-check myself, make sure it hasn't been updated itself, and things such as that nature. But as far as me even reaching the level of intellect, this is something that's always been a part of me as far as having an inquiring mind. And basically, I've disciplined myself to the point where not only do I follow my spirit, but I actually can sit down and learn. You see, a lot of people can't read a book. They don't have the attention span or mind focusing criteria needed to actually sit down and read a book. And I know that sounds crazy, but it's the truth. So for me, you know, I've actually prepared myself and developed myself to be where I am today, following my spirit. I've always loved information. I've always known the truth and been in tune with the truth. And I've utilized my youth to do something now so that I wouldn't have to do it later. So for me, getting where I am now just comes from, what's a good word? Consistency in educating myself. And I believe that shows improves for itself on my YouTube, as well as the fact that I've put over 270-something videos of information out all by myself without no help, nobody cheerleading me or anything like that. Plus, I'm doing lectures and still constantly producing new information at basically on two different platforms, in person and on a YouTube. So this goes to show the constant strive, you know, to constantly be better. So I am where I am today due to discipline and consistency in following my spirit.
That's what's up. Yeah, this is actually, man, this is one of the most important subjects right now. You know, we're talking about healing the community so that we can heal ourselves, and we are there. We're already there at that God point. We're there on this throne. We just need to realize that we need that healing in our spirits and our minds to realize that right now. Now, we're talking about healing each other. Do you know anything about Tantra or anything like that and how that could help with the healing of our nation, of our black nation?
Oh, yeah, I'm definitely intuitive and informed in the subject area known as Tantra yoga, but, you know, we have to understand that these practices will not prepare you, because you must already be prepared for these practices. So, you know, before we go into that, I don't want anybody thinking that, oh, if you do some tantric sex, it'll amplify your frequency or amplify your soul. No, if you're a piece of shit and you try tantric sex, you're just going to be a piece of shit who tried tantric sex. It's not going to really work. So we have to understand that, you know, these practices are meant to raise kundalini energy. But your kundalini energy is raised, predicated upon the opening of your chakras. So certain personalities and psychological traits, as well as stored memories of experiences, close off certain chakras. For example, if you're a person who was beat as a kid or abused, chances are you're going to have a closed heart chakra, or it won't be opened as much as it should be. And this is probably the most important chakra that you have, because this is a gateway between the higher and lower self. So if you're doing tantric sex or tantric yoga and you're raising your kundalini energy, it's going to get caught and discharged in the heart chakra every time, which can also lead to back pains and chest pains, which I broke down in my lecture I'm doing called Spirit Science. So, and I'll be giving that same lecture again next month, June 17th, in Buffalo City. So with that being said, you know, before we even go into those, you don't want people thinking that the practice will help you. No, the practice is to elevate you once you already reach a certain level where you need to be. If not, you're going to be just doing the practice for no reason, and for reasons other than what it's for. But, yeah, when we're dealing with tantric sex, assuming that a person is already spiritually prepped.
Excuse me.
Assuming that a person is already spiritually prepped, what tantric yoga does is it basically allows the sexual energy conjured up within a person during and before, or during or at the anticipation stage of sex, right, to be transmuted up the spine into the brain, where the pineal gland is actually open like a door, because it separates the third ventricle of your brain, the fourth ventricle of your brain, and it allows a liquid melanin that's actually created in the neuromyelinated nerve tract of your brain and stored to the third ventricle to actually spill out and glaze the fourth ventricle of your brain, activating what is known as psychic ability. So a lot of black people don't tap into this octave of themselves, because you never reach that octave, because your chakras, it's like playing a, I always like to tell people, imagine you playing a flute and it's dirty. You don't get the proper musical note. So a lot of your your chakras like your chakras to be like buttons on a flute, and your body's your flute, your instrument. A lot of people are spiritually dirty, so you don't get proper octaves or things like that. So with that being said, you don't get proper spiritual frequencies, I mean proper spiritual experiences that you should have, because a lot of your chakra valves are blocked. So that being said, coming back to the science, once this liquid melanin glazes the fourth ventricle of your brain, it activates these psychic abilities, and you have actual neurons and antennas in your head, known as dipole antennas, that are located within the internal and external layers of your skull, which actually help to commute energy in and out of your brain, and specifically thoughts. So your dipole antennas, once the velocity in which they work is being amplified by the liquid melanin, you have a deeper connection with the universe and your higher self and your third eye, aka your pineal gland. And, you know, to go deeper into this understanding, this is why Egyptians wore the cobras on their head to signify the awakening of kundalini energy. Because once the kundalini energy enters into the brain, the pineal gland actually swells like the hood of a cobra, and the pituitary gland flickers like the tongue of a cobra. And if you pay attention, the male pharaoh's cobra always stood up, and then the female pharaoh's cobras on their head always went down. And that was for ascension and descension of energy. For example, a man, when he wants to project, I mean, the natural flow of a male's energy is projection. This is why protons project energy. The sun is a giant proton. It projects. You project your sperm into a woman's vaginal area. So with that being said, a black woman, the reason a cobra was going down on her pineal gland is because she intakes energy. So we output and she inputs. So with that being said, we have to understand tantric sex is not just for you to be freaky and try sex in a different way. It's to actually
to actually
manifest certain qualities, because you're not even supposed to ejaculate. And your root chakra is the most energy-generating chakra that you have. This is why no matter what you do, you pull energy from your root chakra. If you're angry, you're pulling energy from your root chakra. If you're excited, you're pulling energy from your root chakra. All other six chakras are powered by that one chakra. So that being said, what you're doing is you're learning, what you're doing is you're training your body to pull energy from this chakra but do other things with it instead of ejaculate. So imagine if all the energy you spent generating when you're angry or when you're, you know, when you want to have sex or just when you want your lower self, imagine if you was able to draw that, draw upon that energy and use it for other things, such as martial arts, for example. So with that being said, this is the point of tantric yoga. And this is why when you look in at ancient drawings and paintings or things that have to do with, let's say, martial arts, for example, since we're on that subject, you always see paintings of people who seem to be in sexual positions. This is not because samurais were sexual or ninjas were sexual. It's because they understood the science of that root chakra and that energy. We have to understand, family, you know, we have to come a long way before we can even start talking about tantric yoga, because there's so much irresponsibility going on in the black community. People can't even have safe, regular sex. And it don't even got to be black people's fault. It could be a disease. If we get to talking about tantric yoga, now what do? We do tantric yoga with somebody who has AIDS or something? And, this, you know, this is not a shot at people who may suffer from AIDS, but we have to understand that government understands the science of a person's private part. And they've already, let's say, inflicted damages in these areas. So we have to heal ourselves on so many levels, or at least know your partner, before we can even start involving ourselves in these practices. We have to be psychologically, physically, and spiritually stable. And then after that, we have to make sure that we're biochemically healthy enough to even engage in such a practice. So, you know, we have allowed ourselves to be distracted far from our spirituality, that now as we return to it, we realize the carnage we allow to ensue on what we left behind in regards to what makes us powerful, being our black woman. So, you know, this is a very deep subject. And tantric sex has been practiced for ages. This is why, like, even, you know, I'm not a Christian. I don't really care too much for the stories. But just breaking down the sciences, you know, they say Marilyn Magdalene, or if I'm saying her name correctly, if not, y'all know who I'm talking about, Jesus' alleged wife, who was supposed to be a prostitute, Mary Magdalene, whatever her name is. So, you know, the reason that religious scholars, as they call them, always refer to women in ancient times as prostitutes or whores, or even when you're dealing with Greek mythology, the women always over-sexual, or when you're dealing with Egypt mythology, they always over-sexualize the women, and then it's a saying that everybody's heard before where they say prostitution is the oldest profession. They only say that because they're trying to slander and degrade tantric sex and tantric yoga, because people were practicing that in order to get energy. So they'll say, oh, you know, this woman was a whore, and all of the soldiers used to go to her quarters, or her living quarters, or wherever she lived in the civilization, and they all were having sex with her for money. Well, that's not true. Women have multiple husbands at times, and this might have been four or five husbands that she had, and they might have been warriors or generals, and they practiced tantric sex with their wife, where they didn't even ejaculate. They just might have engaged in a practice to muster up a certain level of energy to go out there and be, you know, warriors. But history is not going to tell you that, because, for one, they don't want women knowing their power, and for two, societies is not ready to hear about women having multiple husbands. So they'll slander it, and they'll say, oh, they was prostituting back in Egypt, or they was prostituting. How the hell they was prostituting with no money, with no banking system? What they was having sex for rocks or crystals? Like, get out of here. So that being said, you know, history loves to slander, you know, the important role that black women played. And black women were ideally the priests. So the same way people go to church and they look to a pastor, this is because we live in the patrilineal system. In our original system, you went to the woman. Just like now, when you're a kid, you hurt, you went outside, you go to mom, you get cut. You don't go to dad, because dad is the spirit, mom is the healer. So in ancient times, when we were living correctly, we always allowed our women to be the healers and the manifestors of our energy. And I'm in that point on this. I did a video before, I believe it was called Sacred Feminine Energy, and I was breaking down how women pull out energy naturally from you just being in their presence. And the example I always use is, I'm like, if you're playing basketball with your friends, with your male friends, y'all just playing. If some beautiful women walk up on that court, niggas going to take their shirt off, niggas going to start trying to dunk, they're going to start trying to do all kind of extra shit. And we have deemed that as showing off, when it's not really showing off all the time. What it is a black woman brings out a natural, let's say, influence on a black man to do better and be in his greatness. And this is all a part of not just tantric sex, but the spiritual abilities that the black woman has on the black community if she's allowed to be where she's supposed to be. So if you paint a picture, you're not going to put as much effort into it opposed to if you're painting it for a girl that you like. She's going to make you put your best effort forth. So when we see that this is happening today in modern times, imagine in ancient times when women was at their fullest energetic capability. So with that being said, imagine the type of warrior you would become if you was fighting for your woman, or if you was being influenced by the energy of your woman versus the ego of niggas like today. So with that being said, you know, our women, when we talk about healing our women, you have to heal your woman because your woman is the gateway to your greatest potential. So when we say the nation can only rise as high as the woman, you see the black community ain't shit right now because we treat our women like they ain't shit. And until we allow the woman, you know, to do what they got to do, we will never be as great as we got to be. And another thing is because we don't understand that technically we are women. And I'm going to back this up, you know, genetically real quick before I go on, because I know people say, I ain't no motherfucking woman, I'm a man. Well, technically, if we're dealing with science, you get your skin tissues and all your, in the majority, 90% of your makeup from a woman. So with that being said, you have the same skin as your mother. So technically, there's no such thing as a man's skin. So there's no such thing as a man. So if you want to be scientific, you know, this shit is like Pokemon. You got Pikachu, and Pikachu evolved into Raichu. You got Woman, and she genetically became man, minus the womb, because the womb went into your rectum. And, you know, I don't know if it's homosexuals on the line, but I'm just to touch on the subject, this is why some men become homosexual, and they ejaculate through anal penetration, because their G-spot goes into their rectum, which you can locate through the anal cavity. So with that being said, you are just a female turned inside out, period. So now with that being, I'm not telling nobody to go be gay or nothing, but I'm just giving the science out. So that being said, when our ancestors understood this, they understood the science of oneness. And this is what oneness is, understanding that you are all beings that are natural, because I don't want nobody out here talking about we one with no. No, every other race is not natural. The motherfucking apples are not one with candy apples. So that being said, everything that is natural, everything that is natural, you are one with. And we used to look at women in the eyes and say, you know what? You are a different manifestation of me. And that's what yin and yang is truly about. So when we talk about, you know, what is spiritual warfare is making you see yourself other than that what you're looking at. So when I see a black woman, I love a black woman because I see myself just a genetic variant of myself, but yet myself. So with that being said, we don't see each other like that in the black community. And due to this spiritual blindness, now we get influenced to fight each other. Oh, I'm the man in the house, and I'm the man. You're not the fucking man in the house, because technically you made up of the same shit this woman is made up. So if anything, she's the man in the house. So we're talking about, you know, matrilineal system. The reason that the woman was able to lead is simple. She was here first. What the fuck? And it's like, you know, black people, I'm going to end on this and let the next question come, but, you know, I want to prove my, this is why I teach the black woman is God so strongly, because niggas will argue over the white man, oh, we was on this land first, this is our land. Well, the black woman was on this planet first, so when does her argument begin, you know? So after you get done arguing with the white man over who had the land first, now she gets to argue with you over how the fuck you got on the land after she had it first. So that being said, you know, niggas want to tell half the story and shit. And this is why we have a problem in the community, because people want to teach what they want to teach and say what they want to say to fit their own personal agenda. And until we become non-egotistical and just start putting facts on the table and letting people digest them for what they are, it's a wrap for the intellectual capacity of black people, as well as the black woman getting back on her throne. So, you know, this is why I campaign the black woman is God so hard and to the extent that I do, because this is a deeper, it's a deeper elevation than what people understand. If the black woman is put back on the throne, nigga, we, where you think we going as black men? This is your number one motivational source. You got dressed today because you know that black women like the outfit that you wear in your community. Because if they didn't, you wouldn't have bought the motherfucker. So with that being said, a black woman wasn't even around when you bought your outfit, and you still bought it in the hope that she noticed it. So if that's not powerful, nigga, I don't know what the fuck is. So with that being said, you know, we have to understand the science and the intricacy and the importance of black women to black people, not even just black men, to all beings of melanated descent, period.
I can dig it, definitely, definitely. And I want to ask you some more questions along the lines. You guys call in 516-453-9174. I am going to get to all the callers. I see a lot of people on the line. But I promised everybody at that time I want to introduce this song by Nut, the Goddess. She is an amazing artist, also known as Connie Muhammad and Nutmeg. An amazing artist out of Phoenix, and a lot of things. This song is actually called BC Black Clandestine, and you guys are going to hear it now. We actually have her on the line right now to introduce the song. The Goddess, are you with us?
Peace, family. Yeah, this song, it's right in line. Peace, young Pharaoh. Love the vibe. Yeah, love what you're saying. Appreciate your work. You know, my daughters appreciate your work. So, yes. So this song should be in the vibe of what we own, Black Clandestine, by DJ Needles.
No doubt. So we're going to get into it right now. Just to let you know a little bit about Nut the Goddess. She was a lyricist, a songstress. She did an album called Ghetto's Child featuring Cool G Rap. She was formerly the Ministry of Arts and Culture for the NOI, and she uses music as a force for change and raising the collective consciousness. So this is an amazing artist. We're coming back with more Young Pharaoh. We're talking about healing the goddess and healing the world. So this is an important subject for right now. So you guys call in 516-453-9174. I am getting to all the callers. This is Nut the Goddess with Black Clandestine, BC.
Prophecies promoted through these scriptures that is quoted out the wormhole that we folded back to the matrix. Overloaded, we conditioned for missions, conducting experiments. This science in your ear, some dope track, you have a cosmic experiment. This DMT got a molecule, manifested you. More will be revealed in time. They chipping fools, got badges. Will be from the black clandestine ancestral supremacy rule, mashing all the obstacles. Sojourn the truth.
I'm the original condom. Activated code, we black with melanated soul. We co-create to reach our goals. We pose significant threats. How to let bad interject. You gon' respect goddesses through the annals of time. Break your fast, feed your mind.
Time traveling out in the prod. I was the queen in ancient Turkey, Phoenicia land denied. Exquisite pricelessness dripping on my head, arms and chest. A dormant of a fear like Quatesh. every 13 jean wrapped in black and violet. Matt and Bridget, voodoo and karma raised my intellect. Dark side of the moon, divine feminine pilot. Everything you seen was mine and all coming after me. We ascend, left you in dark ages, spiritual atrophy. Prophesied iniquity, royalty shed this poverty. Me, ancestors, in tune like galactic camaraderie. Commiserate the shifts. Stop and frisk your energy. I'm here. Elevate your entities that's sending me. Elevate you to the entities that's sending me.
From the original condom. Activated code. We black with melanated soul. We co-create to reach our goals. We pose significant threats. How to let bad interject. You gon' respect goddesses through the annals of time. Break your fast. Feed your mind.
Cultivating concubines. Mother tongue, one third of divine. Triple goddess is the sign who's coming in the end times. Off the grid in big rigs. Living off water and fizz, get mine. What kind of proof you need? My work and my seeds will manifest the climb. What kind of code do you follow? Those who beg, rob, and borrow. Broken with no restoration, inducted by sorrow.
From the original condom. Activated code, we black with melanated soul. We co-create to reach our goals. We pose significant threats. Out of leg, but I interject. You go respect goddesses through the annals of time. Break your fast, feed your mind.
I am Malcolm X.
I am Malcolm X.
I am Malcolm X.
This is Palmetto Star, host of 2RAW4TV. Malcolm X Day is May 19th. It's a day of reflection, reverence, and resistance in the spirit of Malcolm X. We're asking people to buy black and take the day off of work or school. Hashtag CMXD on your social media for more details. Shut down white supremacy and honor Malcolm X this Malcolm X Day, May 19th. If you want to help organize or participate in Malcolm X Day, see what people are doing in your area. Call 803-206-6218 by any means necessary.
Yes, and this year in Atlanta, we will be having a revolutionary meetup at Malcolm X Park in the West End at 3 p.m. on Friday. So you guys want to come out there, 111 Park Street. So you guys definitely want to come out there. There's so much stuff going on with, and I think that relationships between black men and women would heal a lot of that in the community. Now, I want to go into what you were talking about as far as with the masses of our community, because, the masses of our community, to me, they're just following what is available and what is the thing that's most thrown in their face, and that is white subjugation culture, and different variations of that. But, everybody that's on this line, I know, has a degree of consciousness where they're moving forward past that, and it's about that critical mass, We talk a lot about the masses, but that critical mass is what's going to change things, In the end, it's always one person that changes the world. So, that critical mass is very important. What do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. We got Young Pharaoh on the line. Heal the goddess, heal the world. 630, you're on the line with 2RAW4TV and Young Pharaoh. What is your perception on how we should heal our goddesses right now?
Wow. Peace and love, you Palmetto. Peace and love to Young Pharaoh. This is Sky. One of the things that I feel like we should do as women, definitely start creating our own platform, like our YouTube, and also get together, start promoting one another, and talk about the much-needed subjects within our community. Because most of the men in the Black Conscious community, they have their own platform. There needs to be more women that's getting up there and out and having their voice heard.
Did you have a question for Young Pharaoh or anything?
I just have a comment for Young Pharaoh. Young Pharaoh, I used to watch him all the time. Like, he's one of the people who actually helped me transition away from meat. So big kudos, big salute to Young Pharaoh. And he just continues to grow and grow, too. That's very, I know he's always been intellectual, but it's getting stronger, so I appreciate you being on, Young Pharaoh. It's really good to hear your voice and hear you speak on these matters, because we definitely need to get in tune with it.
Thank you. I can most definitely appreciate that, and I definitely salute you on your journey, and I agree with you on the female platforms, but, you know, if I had to interject and, you know, just comment on that, I would say that I want people to understand, because I get asked this all the time, you know, this is not like, and this is not for you, Queen, this is just for people listening. This is not something that I can do, because I know a lot of people say, well, Pharaoh, you always say, you know, we need female speakers. Why don't you, this is not a record deal. I can't put you on. I can bring a female to a lecture with me. That don't mean you know how to teach. See, when it comes to teaching, it's different. If you give me 1 + 1 and tell me it's 2, and you give it to the same person, even though we got the same information, that don't mean we can captivate the same crowd, because we don't have the same mind, personality, charisma, delivery, etc. So I just want, you know, women to know that if you want to teach, you have to use your energy to attract people who's willing to listen to you. So I don't want nobody to feel like, you know, women are not being given a platform, because there is no platform to give you. You are the platform. So I want, you know, women out there to feel motivated and don't feel like somebody can hold you back. Because look at me, I'm 73,000 subscribers strong off of originally posting my videos on Facebook. And the only reason I went to YouTube is because Facebook kept deleting every goddamn page I made. So with that being said, I did this on my own, and y'all can too. But, well, women, you know, you're going to have to be prepared, because, you know, I don't want to say women are emotional, but y'all are more internally in tune than men. And there's some ignorant motherfuckers out here. I'm going to just let y'all know that now. So if you're not strong-minded, or if you're not emotionally strong, or if you ain't ready for this, you know, don't even try it. Because I ain't telling you what could happen. I'm telling you what's going to happen. You are going to be disrespected. You're going to be called out your name. It's like being a doctor in a crazy house. You know, you love the patients, but that don't mean the patients ain't going to try to scratch your damn eyeballs out your face. So you're dealing with a broken community who has a very minimal respect for Black women, let alone feminine energy, period. So if I teach the Black woman is God, and I'm a man, and look at the shit I get called, imagine a Black woman telling a Black man I'm God. Mind you, a nigga ego is coming immediately to the surface. So that being said, you know, the platform is going to be harder for you, because the ego is going to be more present for you. So I just want women to understand that, you know, nobody's stopping you. It's just a hell of a goddamn road you're going to have to walk. And I'm gonna play the fullback and clear the linebackers out as best as I could. But at the end of the day, I can't run through the hole for you. Y'all going to have to run through that hole. So, you know, I would love for a Black woman to be, you know, well-balanced mentally and spiritually. And, you know, we can do a Black woman is God lecture, and she can do what she got to do, you know, because I don't got no shame in my game. I don't have no intentions on not letting a woman do her thing. My thing is just, you know, where are the women to do their thing? So I wanted to just add on to the Queen's statement, so that people can understand, you know, we're not, well, me personally, I can't control nobody else's platform, but I'm not suppressing any Black women at all. I'm encouraging Black women to start speaking up for themselves and sitting on their throne, period.
Yeah, that's what it is. Yeah, exactly. We're about encouraging our women, you know, saying black women, to do what they need to do to push everybody, you know what I'm saying, to the highest, most supreme self that they can be. You guys call in 516-453-9174. We're going in tonight. I am going to get to one more call before I'll ask some more questions, because this is a subject that really we all need to get a grasp of right now, because if we internally heal a collective, progressive moving people, change is imminent. You see the change in Atlanta. You see the change that's happening. It's rapid. It may be chaotic. It looks chaotic right now, but trust me, it's all coming together where it's supposed to be. So you guys call in 516-453-9174. Remember to press 1 so I know that you want to speak. I do have 504. You're on the line with 2RAW4TV and Young Pharaoh. How do we heal the goddess?
All right.
504.
That's for me or that's for the caller?
You can go with it, Young Pharaoh, my bad, because I was going to ask both of you guys, but and 504, remember to press 1 so I know that you want to speak. You guys, if you want to speak, press 1. 251, you're on the line with 2RAW4TV. And Young Pharaoh.
Uh-huh. I mean,
hello?
As far as, yeah.
Hello? Yeah, you're on the line.
How you doing?
I'm doing good. Do you have a question or a comment?
Oh, no, I just want to make a comment. Shout out to 2RAW4TV and shout out to Young Pharaoh, man. This nonfiction represents Mobile, Alabama. And I just want to say, man, I've been following you about since like 2015, and I just want to say, man, I love what you're doing, man. Keep up the good work. We need that type of shit down here in Mobile, Alabama, man. I can't wait. You got to come down here, bro. We need you, man.
I'm going to get back down. I actually came down there before. I gave a lecture down there last year. But I'm going to get back down there. All I need is a venue, and I'm there. So, you know, this ain't even just for you. This is for everybody. If you want me to be in your city, shoot me a venue, and I'm in your city. So it's not a problem. All right, man.
I appreciate that, man. Like I say, just keep up the good work, and I'm just out here listening. I ain't got no question, but, yeah. We need to start standing up for our black women, man. True that.
That's right.
Exactly. Well, hold on the line. We're going to get into this discussion. Call in 516-453-9174. We're going in. Heal the goddess. Heal the world. Now, I want to talk about how can black women access these powers? We talk about motivating the black woman and that she needs to be the one that does that. But is there any way that or any insight that you could give on how they could go about doing that?
I think that black women will be healed once they're stabilized internally. For example, people got to stop thinking that a motherfucker need materialistic things to be in a prime. You know, black women, they're not asking for a mansion. They're not asking for a helicopter, you know. They really not. Even the materialistic, goofy, misguided queens out here that think that that's what they want. That's not what they want. A black woman wants simple things such as honesty, trust, and security. Like, you know, you can't heal somebody if you're damaging them. Let me give you an example, right? If you a lying-ass, cheating-ass, trifling-ass nigga, okay, that is psychological damaging. That's the spiritual equivalent of, like, emotionally stabbing somebody. Like, just like your body heals and gets scabs, your soul, you know, metaphorically stabbed too. And after it's damaged, it has to heal. And just like a lot of scabs and wounds, all of them don't heal back up right. So we talk about, you know, how can we heal the black woman? We got to stop motherfucking damaging her. You know, we dealing with people that's damaged. See, that's the thing. We not understanding that we are the creators of our own experience. Every black woman in the motherfucking black community, whether it's in the inner cities or wherever, right, has their traits that they picked up from their experience with a black man. Now, I know niggas don't want to accept that, but it's the truth. Don't know white people live in the motherfucking ghetto, so they're not the ones fucking over the minds of black women in person. Now, the TV is one thing, but you beating on a motherfucker or cheating on a motherfucker or getting somebody pregnant and leaving them, nigga, that's on you, nigga. You can't blame Love and Hip Hop on that. So with that being said, we are damaging the black woman, period. As black men, we running them through the mud. We treat them like shit. No respect. Nigga won't even hold the motherfucking door for you. So with that being said, we talking about healing the black woman. We got to heal our interaction with the black woman. Once you destroy a motherfucker's trust, you destroy their relationship. See, now let me give you an example, and I'm going to magnify it. You can cheat on a girl, and she'll forgive you. You can beat on a girl, and she'll forgive you. Destroy the trust, and that relationship is over. If a woman can't respect you, it's a wrap for your relationship. I don't give a fuck what you do. I don't give a fuck if you pay all the bills. As soon as she wake up one day, and she say, you know what? I don't respect this nigga. She can't be with you. She ain't going to lay with you. Ain't no sex, nothing. And you know why she ain't going to respect you? Because she don't trust you, because you fucked that up. So with that being said, she's going to take that and she's going to magnify that now on every nigga who comes from the same place you come from who's just like you. And now you're going to have a black woman who doesn't trust trifling-ass black men. And then vice versa. That's just like me. I don't trust the motherfucking police. You know why? Because I've seen them do too much corrupt shit. Now, that ain't saying that every police officer is like that, but goddamn it, I'm not trying to find out. So with that being said, put the black woman in the same position. She'd have been beat on and lied to and misled and mistreated her whole motherfucking life. She's not trying to figure out if every black man going to do that to her because it happened so much, she ain't trying to motherfucking find out. So with that being said, when we want to heal the black woman, we have to heal the motherfucking interaction. You see women get out of relationships with niggas and get with other black men, and they be... It's like they was reborn again. She feeling better about herself. She confident. She doing good. She's healed. You know why? Because she's secure within herself. So we got to stop thinking that materialistic shit is going to make up for the shit that we lack internally. People only try to buy shit to make themselves feel better because they don't already feel good about themselves. And when it comes to black women, thinking that money and buying shit and, you know, oh, I'll take care of my black woman, that's not going to heal her. That's just going to make her not, that shit is like pain medicine. It don't really take away the pain. It just take away the injury. It just take away the pain and make you forget you injured. So that being said, you know, materialistic things is like disrespectful to me in regards to giving to somebody to better them or alleviate the situation. We need to start treating our women better, period. We need to start treating, even if you don't know them, you know. I go into a store, I don't know you. I say, peace, queen. I wouldn't give a fuck if you was at McDonald's. Mother, peace, queen, how you doing? So with that being said, we need to show some respect. And most importantly, I'm going to end on this before we get to the next question. We need to be able to go all out for our women. I'm sick of half-stepping ass bitch niggas, period. If a motherfucker puts their motherfucking hands on our, if 64,000 black women come up, man, okay, I'll tell you what, go to China and make 64,000 Chinese women come up missing, bet your ass don't be bombed tonight, motherfucker. Soon as they find out 10 Chinese women missing, it's going to be Chinese people all over your ass. So that being said, the black man has to become, right, nigga, we need to become demons, nigga. If something happened to a black woman in our community, nigga, we need to be rubbing motherfuckers' blood on our face type shit. Some sick, weird shit. I'm talking about, nigga, you did what?
Yeah.
To a black woman? Nigga, we need to, bitch, we need to chop your hands and feet off and sew the motherfuckers where each other used to go. Nigga, we need to be sewing niggas' hands on their feet and feet on their hands. So that being said, we need to become the lovers to our women and direct all that rage and shit we got in the defense of our women. because too many niggas is frustrated taking their pain out on their woman, but they don't got, they got zero frequency for the real oppressor. Niggas will beat their girlfriend up, their girl called the police. Now this nigga want to talk it out. Where was all that gangster tough throwing shit, punching shit, when it wasn't no Europeans on deck? Now Europeans on deck, and you a fucking Charlie's Angel. So with that being said, you know, we need to become raging dragons in the defense of our women,
yes,
and loving, delicate beings, you know, in the interaction with our women. So until we can do that, it's a wrap for him and the black woman, because that's the only way she can properly interact. If you a fucking goddamn doctor, or you're a healer, you only can do your job in a safe environment. If a motherfucker is throwing grenades in the operating room and shooting up shit, you can't focus on surgery. The black woman is a natural doctor to the community. She's a healer, but she's not in a proper environment for her to do her job, because the goddamn patients in the hospital is fucking up the goddamn hospital. So with that being said, we have to allow her to do her job and create an environment for her to do her job, respect her and acknowledge her for doing her job, and it needs to be hell on earth for anybody who doesn't allow her to do her job. So those are the measures and steps that need to be taken, you know, to heal the black woman, and naturally, once we do our job, she'll do her job. I'm not here to tell, you know, black women what they need to be doing, because I'm not a black woman. I know what the fuck I need to be doing as a black man, and once I do that, then we'll be able to identify if the black woman is doing her job or not. But as a black man, I'm speaking on behalf of me and black men everywhere and what the fuck we need to be doing, period.
I feel that. Definitely feel that. And we have to put it in perspective. We have to see it through our lens, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, in order to get the right healing to our women. So what do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174, 504. Remember, also, if you're on the call, pressing 1, take your phone off mute. I know a lot of people are listening on mute. Take it off so I can get to you. 504, you're on the line with 2RAW4TV and Young Pharaoh. Do you have a question or a comment? Hold on a second. All right. Well, we're gonna get past this little technical issue right here. But this is what I want to say. You know, we talk about healing the black woman and healing the community. Now, what would this look like to you? I mean, when we do heal our women, because it is going to happen. I think there's a lot of people waking up, and I think a lot of the people that, you know what I'm saying, that are there to make changes, such as yourself, you know what I'm saying, influencing people to make those changes, you know what I'm saying, how will that look to see our community healed, in your opinion?
If that's something that I'm able to see in my lifetime, you know, it will look beautiful to see other people doing it, because I see what that's like every day in my goddamn household. See, so we need to know, you know, in regards to seeing black women be healed, that's a public problem. Privately, you know, I love my household. So that being said, you know, I think that on a public scale, you know, it would bring me great joy and seeing people experience each other the way they're supposed to. See, so I don't want to say that. I don't want people to think that this can't be done. If you are a black man in a relationship with a black woman right now, you don't got to wait for the community to get on board to implement the understandings and ways of life that you know you should be living according to. It just will have to be, you know, you and your household, and you and your woman will have to understand that the rest of your people are lost. But this is not something that we need to do as a community. You know, if I'm hungry, I'm going to eat. I'm not going to wait for another nigga to decide he wants to eat too. So when it comes to uplifting the black woman, you know, any black woman I come across, I'm going to deal with them in proper fashion, let alone if we're in a relationship. If we're in a relationship, this conversation I'm having right now is already an understood goddamn fact. So with that being said, I will hope that I live to see the day when black men and black women across the goddamn world deal with each other the way that they should. But if not, shit, that's they goddamn lost, because the proper interaction is going on where I'm at. So with that being said, you know, people only can change and control themselves. Like you said, we only can influence people to walk the correct path. And if a motherfucker don't want to walk that path, you know, I honestly could give two hells because I walk it. So I'm not here to worry about what somebody else is failing to do when I'm too busy focused on how I'm succeeding and doing what I'm supposed to be. So, you know, I want black people around the world to jump on the wave, but I don't want this all to fall on the shoulders of the black man, because a lot of black women is in the same boat as black men. So I don't want, you know, it to be an imbalance here or a misunderstanding, even though we're dealing with, you know, uplifting the goddess, because you got a lot of good black men that get overlooked because you got some wicked-ass women who want a wicked-ass man. So these type of people have to die out. I don't know no other way to say it. You know, we're going to have to protect the children mentally and spiritually from a certain age group and a certain mentality of people until they die the fuck off and their behaviors are no longer passed down. And the behaviors that were passed down was passed down so in such a minimal manner that they don't have an effect on the total population. So, you know, once all of the cleansing and the purging is being done internally in our community, we will be living gloriously internally as far as our activities and our characteristics that we exercise in regards to one another on our in regards to our everyday interactions with each other. Period.
I feel that's real. That's real, and it starts with you. It starts with you. I do want to get to all the callers. 313, you're on the line with 2RAW4TV and Young Pharaoh. Do you have a question or comment? All right. They keep knocking me offline, but it's all good. I will get to all the callers, I promise you, but just keep on knocking me offline. All right, hold on for 1 second. We are turning a hotspot on so we can get some connection, because that's just crazy. But it's all right. I see y'all trying to disrupt the force. But you can't stop the information. Can't stop the information. Can't stop the information. Now, I love what you do. And I looked at something that you have put out recently about how we get energy and information from the sun. And you had said something about, now, I was just trying to get clarification. You have made said something about fresh sunlight. So I was like, okay, what is that specifically, though? You know what I'm saying? So appreciate it. So I was just wanting to get a little clarification on that.
All right, yeah. Everything has, you know, docile aspects of itself. For example, like somebody tell you, go outside to get fresh air. You got air that you've been breathing in has been recycled, and then when you go outside, you have fresh air, which is, you know, air that's yet to be interacted with by the average human. So that being said, you got sunlight, which is light and information that's just been bouncing around this goddamn planet for a certain amount of time, and you have fresh sunlight, which is sunlight that is just entering the atmosphere, void of human interaction yet, and still holding, you know, the purities of its content, being information, et cetera. So it takes sunlight 8 minutes and 20 seconds to reach the planet Earth. And what people don't understand is, you know, a lot of people think the sun is a big gas ball of fire when, you know, common sense tells you there's no air out of space. So how can the goddamn sun be a gas ball of fire when fire needs air to breathe? But et cetera, I mean, but outside of that, the sun is a giant battery. It's a giant ball of electricity which sustains all life within the solar system. So with that being said, every 8 minutes and 20 seconds, the sun is giving you brand new fresh waves of not only electromagnetic radiation, but information. So that's like if I text your phone, and then every eight minutes and 20 seconds, I send you a new text message. That means you're dealing with the old-ass information I gave you until every 8 minutes and 20 seconds, you get a new inbox. So the sun is doing the same thing. It's sending us new information and new frequency every eight minutes and 20 seconds, but we might not be outside to download it because, like I said in the video, the average motherfucker don't even spend 8 minutes and 20 seconds outside. It don't take you 8 minutes and 20 seconds to get outside and go to work in the morning. And by the, some of y'all motherfuckers work, you know, from 7 to goddamn 3. So the sun really ain't even up when you go. And then by the time you get off, you such in a rush to get off, you walk straight to your car and pull off. So you ain't really get no sunlight. It took you about 2-3 minutes to get to your car and pull off and bullshit and get on your phone and do everything you do. Then you didn't drove. You're tired to go pick up the kids or go to the grocery store or run whatever errands you got to run. You didn't spend 8 minutes and 20 seconds outside your car. So then you done went inside this building again, blocking you from the sun. And then from there, you done picked up your kids or picked up your groceries or whatever you did, and you went your ass in the house just happy to be off work, tired, maybe cook food, get the kids ready for school, go to sleep. So your whole day, you've never gotten exposed to any fresh sunlight or fresh information. So that being said, you have to understand, even the internet refreshes itself, goddammit. You niggas is dealing... You niggas ain't even refreshing. So that being said, you know what I'm saying? God damn. So you have to understand the importance of being melanated. You know what I'm saying? Just go the fuck outside for at least 10 minutes and then do your day. I promise you to make a great change in your life. So we have to understand the importance of information. You're like a plant. You literally are a plant, a humanoid evolved plant, if so to speak. And you need the sun to download information, period. Okay, your DNA needs the sun to be activated. It's a new frequency of cymatics being exposed to us. If you're being exposed to the proper amounts of sunlight radiation every day, it's a wrap for you. And sunlight deprivation leads directly to depression in black people. This is a fact. This is not no opinion. Black people are more depressed outside of sunlight because sunlight activates certain biochemicals inside of us, which are antidepressants, which act as antidepressants, being serotonin being one of them, which is released during the daytime hours. So if you're never exposed to a proper amount of sunlight for 12 hours out of 24 hours a day, you're not producing serotonin, which out of the many things that it is, its main three functions is to stabilize the emotional, psychological, and neurological aspects of a being. And it's an antidepressant. So that being said, you know, lack of sunlight is one of the most negative effects that black people allow ourselves to experience in our community, period. And we need to clean that up. We need to understand who we are. You know what I'm saying? Jesus and Allah has our natural connection to the Most High, which is the sun. The sun is the highest thing within your vision. So when we say the Most High, the universe is the Most High. Because when you look up, there's nothing higher than celestial light. So that being said, you have a biological world inside you. You have a world of cells and genes and things like that inside you that actually are intelligent and help you to live. Well, we call that biolife or biological life or genetic life, a.k.a. life forms. You have what is known as celestial life, the planets, you know, the galaxies, the Milky Way, the comets, the wormholes, the black holes. All this is called celestial life, and this plays a part on your biological self. So there is not an aspect, anything you can see, you're connected to it, period. It is actually playing a part on who you are. So we have to understand the Most High is the universe. And an agent of the universe in this particular realm of creation is this particular sun, because this particular sun generates and sustains all life in its solar system. So with that being said, we have replaced the solar system with religion. And this is why we're not winning. This is why we're losing. So with that being said, we need to take back our natural interaction and understanding of the cosmos and continue to apply that to ourselves like we used to, And then once that happens, we will start to see the same results that we used to see. So I'm going to end on this. You know, there's a saying where people say, if you want results that ancient people had, you have to practice the way ancient people practice. So with that being said, you know why niggas in karate class today ain't breaking no bricks or bending no motherfucking iron spears with their necks? Because they not practicing the way that ancient martial artists used to. So niggas wearing gloves and pads for every goddamn thing today and wonder why they can't punch through a brick wall. And then you wonder why a Buddhist monk can punch through a brick wall and kick down a tree. Because he's not wearing no pad, no padded shit. He's practicing organically. So with that being said, we have to get back to our organic foundation of spirituality, which is the cosmos, period.
No doubt, absolutely. I do want to get to all the callers, and I know a lot of people have questions. You're on the line with 2RAW4TV.
Yes, I just had a question, Young Pharaoh, about womb wellness, because when you're talking about healing and, you know, healing the goddess, I'm pretty sure you'd agree that that's the major component and that pretty much anyone can do it. You know, any woman can learn that science. So can you expound a little bit on womb wellness and also some of the, I say, unscrupulous business going on around that where pretty much, you know, sisters are being conned into thinking they have to pay all this money and, you know, their spirituality being misconstrued and confused and a lot of other things behind the womb wellness. So with that movement and the positive aspects of it, can you expound on that?
I mean, your genital areas have to do a lot with your confidence. Let's just say that. So, you know, the wellness of a woman's womb has to do, will affect her internal being tremendously. Let's just say that. But in regards to that, I think that by me not having a womb, right, I wouldn't be qualified to break down the totality of the experience of what it would be like to have a womb, you know, in a well condition. So scientifically, I could break down, you know, the perplexities of the womb. But I think that this is where it's important that a woman becomes educated in not just physical but metaphysical sciences so that she can take this understanding to the extent that we need in particular moments like this, because it's only so far I can go. For example, right now I can break down, you know, how the woman's womb is the same exact geometric shape of certain parts of the cosmos that give birth to things like suns and other matter. I can break down, you know, the blueprint of a woman's vagina metaphysically and physically, or biologically or bioenergetically. But it's hard for me to, you know, break down the experience in the actual, let's say, rewards of womb wellness, because I don't have a womb. So it's like I can tell you how to – it's like a football coach. I can tell you a play to run, but I don't have the experience of actually running the play because I'm not a player. I'm just the mastermind of the science that I can't experience at this from this level of my being. So I think that a woman, you know, will be more fit to take this question more in detail in the way you asked me, because I'm not a woman. So I don't want to get on here and give a false experience. But I do know that for a fact it is very important for a woman to have her womb, you know, in a well manner. And this is another reason why we need to come together, because a lot of women, you know, and not to make jokes, but, you know, growing up as a youth, which a lot of people can attest to, a lot of women don't know how to wash themselves. A lot of men don't know how to wash themselves. So this is where women, you know, the sisterhood comes into play, because you got a lot of young girls out here who, let's say, they might go through a lot of ridicule and things like that growing up. And they got to get emotionally beat down and abused and made fun of, all because somebody didn't teach them something as simple as taking care of the most important part of their being, because there wasn't a woman around responsible to do such a thing, or vice versa. So with that being said, you know, women, this is y'all duty to each other to make sure that y'all understand the sacred science of yourselves that nobody else can understand but you. I can only study you, but the greatness of you, it will always be your personal secret. So, you know, this is something that women in the community are going to have to actually take seriously and maturely, keyword maturely, come together on and implement and make sure that it's foundated, respected, well known, and most importantly, upheld, period.
Exactly. And I do want to say that we are back online. So you guys press 1 if you want to speak, press 1. Call in 516-453-9174. I do want to get to all the callers. 313, you're on the line with 2RAW4TV. Do you have a question or comment for for Young Pharaoh?
Yes. My question is, I know Young Pharaoh, he was saying earlier that if the, you know, the black man was cheating, you know, stuff like that, that helps really destroy, you know, the woman. But so I guess my first question is, well, what sets the guidelines? What sets the guidelines to say a man can't actually be with another woman? Because, like, say for instance, if I'm a man and I feel like that it's okay for me to be with another woman, and if my woman have a problem with it, I believe that's westernized thinking. So, you know, just because she gets upset, I think she should learn the way that I'm trying to do it, which is, hey, a man should have more than one woman, and you should accept that because in nature, a lion don't just sleep with one lioness. Even a dog don't just sleep with one dog. You know, so, you know, I'm not, you know, trying to say we're animals, but just in, yeah, I can suppress my nature, but I feel it's okay. I feel it's in my nature that a man can be with multiple women. I think a woman should learn it that way. So my first question would be, who sets the guidelines, or what material, you know, should we read, ancient material that says, hey, you can't be with another woman? So I guess that's the first question.
Okay. I like that question. I'm going to answer that. You see, when people say in nature, right, what are we talking about? Because in nature, the females kill the male spider after they have sex. So we're going to follow nature. Shit, your woman should be able to slit your motherfucking throat after sex. So my thing is, when we say who sets the guidelines, we do. And we have to understand that everybody's understanding is not the same. Now, here's my point, right? Hypothetically speaking, I can guarantee you ain't tell your woman, I'm a man and I'm going to be having sex with multiple women. You know why? Because unless she whips some shit like that, she won't be in a relationship with you. Because a relationship is founded upon understanding. Now, it's one thing if you're in a polygamous relationship and that's your woman's understanding and she's cool. But for you to just say, oh, I'm going to be, what is cheating? Cheating is you said you would only have sex with me and you're having sex with somebody other than me. That's called motherfucking cheating. So we can't use polygamy for an excuse for why a motherfucker didn't keep their word. See, even with polygamy, you can't just be if you do a polygamy and you got one wife, y'all both, and mainly the woman, should be searching for your next wife. That don't mean you out here just testing motherfuckers out and fucking everything because of polygamy. So with that being said, the guidelines are set by you via natural common sense and discipline. So I don't think that nature has anything to do with a motherfucker telling a girl they're going to be with him and then cheating and saying, well, I'm a man. Because if that's the case, you should have said that shit off the rip. How you doing, baby girl? What's your number? Oh, by the way, I'm into polygamy, so if you're not, you might as well not even take my number or whatever. Because shit needs to be made off the rip. So when we say, what is cheating? Cheating is when you say one thing and you do another motherfucking thing. That's what cheating is. Cheating is not, oh, I said this and I got caught, but I'm going to use black power and pro-black shit and all of this shit to give an excuse for why the fuck I blatantly looked you in your face and told you a motherfucking lie and did the opposite of what I said. So now I'm bringing that back off full circle. You know, we forget that women have had multiple husbands too. So now why is it important? It's whatever floats your boat. See, we don't want to keep talking about the glories of men and not talk about the glories of women, because if your woman was to tell you, well, nigga, I've been reading this book, nigga, and Queen Zinga had two husbands, so I want two niggas, you would probably shit your motherfucking pants. So with that being said, the reason I'm saying this is because every woman don't want multiple men. I don't know a woman who does. But if a woman was to want multiple men, would you respect being one of her husbands the way you would want her to respect being one of your wives? So we not being fear. And I think that people need to find people who are on the same way. For example, I don't want a woman that wants multiple men. So I will find a woman who only wants one man. That works for me. But if I did, I will find a woman who wanted me and another man. So I'm not here to, we're not here to judge or make people succumb to what we want. We're here to find people who already want what we want. And if not, we can't be manipulating people and showing them that we're one person to get what we want from them. And then when our true colors come out, we say, well, what is cheating? Because in nature, no, it don't work like that. Because in nature, a lot of shit happens. In nature, like I said, motherfucking females not only have multiple sex partners, the majority of female animals and insects kill the male after sex. So if we going to follow nature, you niggas need to start bringing guns in the bedroom and letting them blow your motherfucking brains out after sex. Because if we going to follow nature all the way, half the fucking male population to be dead every Saturday and Friday. So with that being said, you know, the point of this is finding somebody who already shares your ideology on how a relationship should go, whether it's monogamous, whether it's motherfucking polygamous, whether it's polyandry, whether it's even homosexuality. I'm not promoting homosexuality, but you see Jerry Springer, when a motherfucker go in there and they say, I was born a man. The reason they start fighting is because the one nigga had no clue of this person's intent in regards to their sexual preferences or their relationship preferences. Two gay motherfuckers don't fight because they already knew what it was off the rip. So if a nigga had plans on not being faithful, you should have said that shit at getting a number. You should have said, listen, sweetheart, I don't got plans on having no girlfriend, but I want to interact with you via this, that, and the third, and gave her the chance to choose if she wanted to deal with an ain't shit nigga or not. You shouldn't have package deal, and I ain't talking about you, I'm just going in general. A man shouldn't package deal himself as something, and then when she opened up the goddamn gift motherfucking box, it ain't shit in there. So now she didn't already psychologically prepare herself for one type of person, and she got another type of person. And I just did a video on my damn channel about this yesterday, I believe. But that being said, when it comes to men wanting to have sex with as many women as they want, you can do that. Just find somebody who doesn't care if you do that. Don't do that shit with somebody who you know is not with that. Mind you, if we're talking about consciousness, we need to be conscious of the fact that we grew up in a world that's ran by Europeans, where they illegalize polygamy because they know that's an African style of relationship. Damn near only, I don't know any states. All I know is motherfucking, I think Las Vegas. I don't know any states in America at all that will let you legally marry under polygamy, and I might be wrong about Las Vegas. So with that being said, 90% of Africa will let you get married under polygamy. Damn near only 5% of America will let you get a polygamy license. So that being said, our women, even though we're African, don't even identify with an African style of relationship, and neither does the African male, because the same way women say, I can't share my man, that's the same way a man say, I can't share my wife. So it goes both ways. So it all comes down to this, and I'm going to end on this. Let a motherfucker know what you about up front. Let a motherfucker know what you believe in. Let a motherfucker know what you're looking for. Let a motherfucker know how you plan things to go. And go off that, or go off hand. You know what I'm saying? And I don't think that a motherfucker who doesn't have a successful one-on-one relationship should be even thinking about polygamy or polyandry or whatever. If a motherfucker can't have a successful one-on-one relationship, they do not need to be talking about no having multiple wives or husbands. Because a lot of motherfuckers is immature, and it only comes down to sex at the end of the day. It don't even be about building. You know what I'm saying? It don't even be about nation building and doing right by the kids. It just be about, if here's a woman who will let me have other women, a lot of women looking for some security, and, you know, they just found who they thought was a conscious nigga, and now you got niggas fucking up two lives at the same time instead of one. So, you know, we need to deal with these situations delicately, but bringing it back to the original source, you know, we can't allow our actions to be excused if we didn't keep it real. Now, hypothetically speaking, if a man was to tell a woman off the gate those are his intentions, then she has no room to get mad because you knew what this nigga was about off the gate. But 9 times out of 10, niggas is not telling women, hey, give me your number so that I can have sex with not just you, but any women that I want to because I'm a man and I'm allowed to have multiple women. No, niggas ain't doing that, and it don't even work like that.
That's real, that's real. Oh, did you have any other questions, V13?
Yeah, I would definitely like to agree that I believe men should be honest. You know, I mean, especially, you know, just like a gentleman like myself, you know, when I met my old wife, you know, I did, you know, let her know I believe in the Bible and I get that particular concept from the Bible. So I do believe, you know, that men should be honest. You know, you should never lie or, like you said, put up a facade. I definitely agree with that. Then I guess my next question would be, because I know you were saying that, you know, the woman is God. And, you know, so my thoughts was, okay, if the woman is God, you know, why is it our responsibility or the man's responsibility to do all of this? Why can't the woman just do what she's supposed to do if she's God and everything should fall into place? I mean, why is it? It would appear that the man is God if the man is held responsible for, hey, protect her or do this or do this, or we're trying to say, what do we need to do? Wouldn't it be, what does the woman need to do to take her throne? Why is the responsibility on the man if she's God? So I think that, you know, I think we actually reversing the roles. I really think the man should be a man and not put the woman out front and put the responsibility on the woman. I think the man should be a man. I believe the man is a protector, but I don't want to put the woman out front saying she is this and she is that, because if she is all of that, then why don't she just do what she need to do? Then everything will be straight.
Same reason that niggas don't do what they need to do, and everything ain't straight. I mean, that's like saying if the president is the president, why do we got bodyguards? Why they not the president? Because their job is to protect the head of what is important. The woman is the head of what is important. And, you know, when it comes to the black woman being God, you know, this is genetic proof. Like, for example, right, I know the brother just said he believe in the Bible, which I'm not here to attack anybody's religion. But, you know, without turning this into a debate, a man is an XY chromosome. A woman is an XX chromosome. A XY chromosome, right, which is man, is an XX chromosome minus 2.8% of his own genetic mass. So this is why you have nipples and you never use them. Your body is actually defective. We're the only people on the planet who don't use 100% of our being. So now why is it important? This is because you are a woman minus 2.8% of her own genetic mass. Now in your book, it said, in that Bible, it says Eve came from Adam, which is a lie because we can prove scientifically that man came from woman because there would be no such thing as man unless woman lost 2.8% of her own genetic material. So now with that being said, not only is there a fallacy within, you know, the Genesis level of the book, which Genesis means origin and production of something, this goes to prove that the mystery God who wrote the book allegedly is either a goddamn liar or the book is man-made. So now why is this important? Because the reason most religious people, you know, it's hard for them to fathom women in a powerful state is because religion takes that away. It's a patriarchal book written by patriarchal entities, a.k.a. non-Africans. I'll give you an example. Tells you a woman does in the Bible is bring sin around the world. So imagine being a woman, right, and you growing up, and you a little girl, and your parents tell you, you know that you get your period because Eve bit the apple, and that's why it's sin in the world. So subconsciously, you feel like the world is fucked up because of you. Now, that's some fucked up psychological shit to tell a woman. Outside of that, every religion mimics this same bullshit understanding. So now we have men who feel like a woman is a sidekick, and shit is their fault. And just like even here on the phone, I don't, you might not have meant to do it, but you said if women just do this, you know, or that, everything will be all right. But what can they do? What power do they have? We've taken all the motherfucking power. What can they do? There's no president women. There's no women who control military. You can't name one goddamn national military power that's ran by a female. You can't name one goddamn top company that's ran by a female. You can't name one goddamn space station that's ran by women. Don't have no power, let alone a black woman at that. The black woman, before she get any type of power, she got to go through the white woman, Chinese woman, Korean woman, Filipino woman. Spanish woman. It's so many different genetic variations of women that the black woman has been placed under, right? That what the fuck can she change? So the most power that a woman, that a black woman has is in her home. And we don't even let her have that power because we too busy trying to take that. Because now a nigga wants his food cooked when he come home. Now a nigga wants this made. Now a nigga wants that made. To the point where she has become that same sidekick that she was in the Bible. So with that being said, we are dethroning our women due to a misunderstanding of who they are. Because we are afraid that them becoming greater makes us lesser. When really it rises us both together. Balance, as I stated before. Every man has female skin, female bones, female brain. You are a female turned inside out. So when you look in the mirror next time and you wash your face, know that you wash it a female's face. This is science. So with that being said, there is no such thing as technically different genders. There's only different genetic variation. So I'm going to say it again. It's like Pokemon. Pikachu turns into Raichu. Your wife turned into you. So when you understand that, you'll understand the importance of giving her her power back, because you're giving yourself your power back. So a lot of the misconceptions that we have on the black woman is because we forgot that they us. So literally, it could be your sister, your grandma, a stranger. Next time you see her, say, that's me, because it is you. Your testicles is just protruding ovaries. That's it. Her womb is now your rectum. Her nipples are now your chest, period. So that being said, everything a woman has, you have, just a different genetic appearance. So with that being said, we like, you know, I want to say it a positive way because I don't want people to think I'm man-bashing because I am inside of a vessel that we would call a black man. But with that being said, we are just women minus 2.8% of their own self. That's the nicest way I can say it. They were here first. It is from them in which we descend. You know, no disrespect, but religion is full of shit and was written by oppressors to take away this truth. And, you know, this is not a ego thing. I don't do this to bash people's religion. I'm just telling the truth. And we're talking about God. Excuse me. God is an acronym. G-O-D stands for generator, organizer, and dispenser. The black woman is a generator, organizer, and dispenser of all physical reality as well as spiritual reality, because you can't even reincarnate into another vessel unless you come through the womb of a black woman, because only things that contain melanin are actually living. So with that being said, she is God, and it is from her womb in which we came. And I can go into Bible verses and all of that right now where God is a female, but I'm not going to do all that. So with that being said, you know, it's our fault as black men to allow the black woman to flourish, and it's because of subconscious insecurities that we don't want to acknowledge that is the reason we don't. For example, some niggas don't want their girl leaving out the house looking too good because we don't want another nigga looking. When really, if we were secure and we had the woman that we think we have, I wouldn't give a fuck if she went outside butt naked, because I know you can't get my woman. So with that being said, we need to develop those type of relationships. And those type of relationships are developed by allowing your woman to be in her glory. Now, that don't mean allowing your woman to walk around naked, but a mature person understand what I'm trying to say. Let her be her. Our only job is to protect and support, not control and contain. An egotistical, fearful person controls and contains what they fear they're going to lose. A spiritual and loving person allows what they have to be free because they know it's always going to come back. There's no such thing as losing something you don't own. We all still have slave mentality. We think we own each other. A motherfucker ain't pay for me. It's not damn woman on the planet Earth that got a receipt for Young Pharaoh, which means technically I don't have to listen to shit you say because you don't own me. Now, I can do things that you like and approve of and never disrespect you because I'm in accordance with your feelings, but technically you don't own me. So until we understand that we don't own each other and that we're just lovingly interacting with each other, a lot of the understandings will not be understood because we're not at a psychological point to see straight in our own mind, period.
I feel that. And you touched on polygamy, you touched on polyandry, and our ancient systems, and people do forget that, you know, women did have multiple husbands as well. There's 5 minutes in the live stream. You guys press 1 if you want to have a comment or question. The number is 516-453-9174. And I do want to, at this time, just briefly thank all my listeners, all my supporters that have been here. 2RAW4TV has been the fight since November 4, 2010, and bringing it to different platforms. You know, we've gone viral, went on CNN, Fox News. But we are here to fight for the community, and you guys could help out by giving a free will donation to 2RAW4TV Radio@gmail.com via PayPal, and this will help us in the next 3 months help organizations with suiting up. We're helping club organizations. We're also providing a spot for homeless people in the city of Atlanta, and we're also organizing a after-school program for awakened teenagers. These are our goals for the next 3 months, so if you guys could help out and donate via PayPal to 2RAW4TV Radio, that's the number 2RAW4TV Radio@gmail.com. We are not just a radio show. This is a movement. Now, I do want to say, man, you have been bringing some very poignant points, you know what I'm saying, and letting people know about what's going on and what's happening as far as us healing each other, and I think we've come to a new understanding about how to do that. Now, can you tell people where they can find you at online and in the streets?
Most definitely. Y'all can find me online, Pharaoh_Allah for Instagram, also Pharaoh_Allah for Twitter. That's Pharaoh_Allah. Pharaoh_Allah for Instagram, Pharaoh_Allah on my Twitter. Also Pharaoh_Allah for my Snapchat. And you can hit me up on Facebook at Young Pharaoh. And my YouTube, it was Pharaoh_Allah, but now it's Young Pharaoh. I changed from Pharaoh Allah to Young Pharaoh for legal reasons. So with that being said, you can follow me on YouTube now at Young Pharaoh. And get ready, family, because I'm not playing no games when it comes to this wave of information. So, you know, I want to thank the brother, you know, for having me on 2RAW4TV. You know, this is the first time I came on this platform. And, you know, I thank them for having me on. And it's just... It was a beautiful night. Much relevant information was shared. You know, I want to thank all the callers, all the questions that was asked, and I just want everybody to know that, you know, we're going to do what we got to do, but first it's going to have to be done inside each and every one of us individually. You know, and until we understand that, everything else is in vain. You know, you are your own priority, and you are your own, objective. On this mission called life, outside of your goddamn children. So with that being said, family, have a beautiful night. You know, I want to thank the brother once again for having me on. Much love, and I want y'all all to enjoy y'all night and uplift that goddamn black woman. You know, uplift that black woman. And if you got a problem with uplifting the black woman past your own views, we'll at least hold her equal to them. So, you know, that's my challenge to the black man today. If you feel like it's a God or there's a Bible or it's something in your life that makes you, you know, hesitant to believe the black woman is more important than that, then at least put her on the same goddamn playing field. At least do that. We can at least do that. So with that being said, you know, give her back her motherfucking throne, man. Goddamn. And with that being said, you know, I am the lawyer and representative for black women internationally, globally, and intergalactically. And I believe that I always come in here and represent black women to the fullest capacity. So with that being said, black woman, I love y'all. The black woman is God. Have a good night. Peace.
No doubt, no doubt. That's Young Pharaoh bringing that fire information. Big time shout out to him and what he got going on. But real briefly, man, I know you had mentioned a date when you're going to be somewhere, but can you tell the people where you're going to be at next? Real briefly.
Oh, most definitely. I'm gonna be in Buffalo, New York, my hometown, my city, come through June 17th. And I'm bringing in the general. So y'all know we not playing no game. I'm bringing in the general. This is a SOS BPC Black Ops operation. Come through, and I'm going to give y'all a secret. He going to give one of his best lectures. I'm going to give one of mine. So y'all going to get the best of both worlds. We not even playing no game. We ain't even going dynamic duo this time. We just coming smash, smash. So y'all better be in the building June 17th, Buffalo, New York. Y'all know this is my city. Come through, holler at me. Y'all can kick it with me after the lecture. This is my city. We could go out, do what we do, and enjoy ourselves like adults. And after that, I'm going to be in Bompton, a.k.a. Compton, again, doing a meet and greet June 30th, right? The flyers on my Instagram as well as my Facebook, and I'm going to do a YouTube video promoting the lecture, family. And then the following day, which is July 1st, me and the general giving a PowerPoint presentation called, I believe it's called The Secrets of the Occult. So, you know, we breaking down all kind of, I'm not even going to say nothing. Miss that goddamn lecture if you want to.
Right.
If you miss that lecture if you want to. So, we not playing no games, family. And I'm going to be in Indianapolis, I want to say July 23rd. But watch out for the flyer so I can make sure my date is correct. And, you know, we on our way out there as well. So, shout out to the guy that's putting that together. So, you know, I'm basically trying to hit as many cities as I can every other week this entire summer until we can wake our people up. So, Buffalo, New York, June 17th. Family, get ready. Secret City of Call, July 1st. L.A., Compton, get ready. Biological Computer live stream I'm doing at the end of this month. Y'all know how my live stream lectures be, straight fire. That's on the 28th of this month. You can get your tickets for any of these events I just named at youngpharaoh.eventbrite.com, family. So with that being said, get with me and get this information.
Hey, man, someone just hit me up and asked, how much does the live stream cost?
My live stream is $20. They can go right on youngpharaoh.eventbrite.com and see.
All right, that's what it is. That's what it is. Check out Young Pharaoh. He's doing his thing. Very important information. So I know a lot of people are on the line. You know, this is one of those shows that you want to tell people about and click on afterwards just to re-listen to the information that was delivered. So big time shout out to Young Pharaoh. Definitely doing his thing. Check him out. Also, very important, Malcolm X Day, May 19th. That's next Friday. Meet us at Malcolm X Park in Atlanta, then West End at 3 p.m., 111 Park Street. It's going down. It is a revolutionary meetup for Malcolm X Day. Of course, take that day off. Don't go to school. Don't go to work. Wear black. It's going down across the country, Malcolm X Day, May 19th. So definitely big-time shout-out and salute to you, Young Pharaoh. You're definitely doing your thing. You guys check them out. I want to play this song by King Simba. It's called By Any Means. And I just want to encourage everybody to win the revolution within. It's 2RAW4TV.
By Any Means. Away from America's dreams. Follow Mac, I'm fiends, black power, all black, everything, let nothing intervene. I'm missing the imposter, ain't far-fetched, yet and seen. By any means, salute to the red, black, and green. Road of frustration in between, puffin' blows, steam beyond time to redeem. And rearrange the scene, fuck you mean. Going for the glory, not a dream. Stand stoop for revolution, tired this hypocrisy, this democracy. Why set up a mediocrity, this whole setup? It's full of imposters, they give a chitlin'. Why they eating faking lobsters? Call themselves a government, just a new age of mobsters. Our dignity's through it. For 500 years, we let them do it. Can't you see? They feeling like we stupid. But really, we got the greater minds of mass and our ability to build nations. With maximum stability, armies for security. We don't need leaders, it's everyone's responsibility. Most of us comfortable with fears and insecurities. In the sympathy, by any means. Away from America's dreams and united as a team. Follow Malcolm's schemes, black power, all black everything, let nothing intervene. I'm missing the imposter, ain't far fetched yet, you see. By any means, salute to the red, black, and green. Roll the frustration in between, pumping blows, stay beyond time to redeem. And rearrange the scene, fuck you mean. Going for the glory, not the cream. Wanna be taking steps, stand together how it's meant to be. Numbers don't lie, neither does our history. Not a mystery, it's written in stone. We roll a seat, what is pushing we on? All these thugs, all these niggas, all these bitches, all these hoes. Baby daddy, mamas with a family, nobody knows. That's reality shows, no important enough I know. Social media trends, bring mature relationships, goals. Proud of the ghetto, stolen from my empire. You don't care, you happy watching empire. Embarrassed by your culture, idolize the image of beauty. Redefine ourselves, it's our personal duty. Piety needs away from America's dreams. They united as a team, follow Malcolm Steen. Black power, all black, everything, let nothing intervene. I'm missing the imposter, ain't far-fetched yet to see. By any means, salute to the red, black, and green. Roll the frustration in between, pumping blows, stay beyond time to redeem. And rearrange the scene, fuck you mean. Going for the glory, not the cream. You ain't fed up, ready to add up, and you ain't woke yet. Ain't talking liberation, restoration, you ain't spoke yet. Done enough talking, time to handle our business. Sacrifice for progression, survival of the fittest. Down or lay down, you lay down, you stay down, you stay down, or you play clown, you straight clown, or you play round, no asking, no begging, we come in to take it, put that wall up, no hold up, come and pull for to break it, fake it if you want to, that's something that we want to, by any means necessary, don't say I didn't warn you, political, gangster, revolution warrior, free at last, can't destroy my aura. Away from America's dreams, stand united as a team. Follow Malcolm schemes, black power, all black, everything, let nothing intervene. I'm missing the imposter, ain't far fetched yet to see. By any means, salute to the red, black, and green. Roll the frustration in between, puffing blows, stay beyond time to redeem. And rearrange the scene, fuck you mean. Going for the glory, not the cream.